Okay, good afternoon. Well, we're going to start our workshop for level 3, grammar review, because we're close to our final examination, okay? So the first thing I wanted to go over a little bit was something related with the platform, okay? Okay, so first thing, remember that here. Remember when you enter your class, here when you enter your class, you have in the first layout right here, remember you can always go to calendar, class calendar. Inside the class calendar, you are going to find all the important dates. When the blog starts or ends, when you have a webinar, and so on. But most important, remember you can go to the first day of class, which was October 18th. And there you will find the syllabus, for example, the syllabus, the score and rubric, how to download Flash Player so you won't have problems in the platform. It's important you can update your Flash Player. So you just press here, and then inside you can go to, you will find the link, okay, the link to download. Just press this link and it will take you to the page where you can just download it, okay? So it's important that you have your Flash Player updated, okay? And things you can find there also, the syllabus, which is important. You can go to your syllabus. There is the time where the tutor is going to be at in the message board. Here in the syllabus, you also have the score of how the points that you have for each thing that you do, the policies and regulations, and the dates where we have blog one, forums, and all that, okay? Also, there's a way that you can do your activities. It doesn't mean that if you don't do it in this date, you can't do it. You can actually do it during the weekend or whenever you have time. And also the dates for the final presential exam, the makeup exam, and all that, okay? It's very important to remember that only the students that have worked in the platform will have the opportunity for the makeup exams, for supletorios, okay? So remember to do at least a lesson so you can have the opportunity to take the makeup exam, the examen de supletorios, okay? And here in the content, remember that the platform gives you 10 points, okay? Platform gives you 10 points. The 10 points are distributed in the following way. 2 points for the course, for this part right here, where you learn actually all the grammar and all the things you need to learn are here. 2.4 is you have the workbook and then the test so you can evaluate yourself and practice for the final exam. So the course gives you 2 points, the workbook 1 point, and the test 1 point, all the tests 1 point, okay? Then the blog gives you 2 points. Remember, we have 4 blogs during the semester. So with those 4 blogs, you get 2 points. Remember, you enter here, and the blogs can only be done during that week. the week that you have for block three, for example, okay? After the deadline, all blocks that you post, the grade's going to be zero, okay? So it's important to check the dates and do it on time. Same thing for the forums, okay? But the forums are worth 4 points. But you have to do it during that week. If you cross the deadline, well, you're not going to be able to be graded, okay? Your score will be zero. So it's important to do it on time. Here, remember you have to press forum 3 grado productor, and then once you enter and you see the form that the tutor has placed and recorded, you can even listen to the recording.
Hypothetical situation. If you were caught for a day.
Then press reply. Once you are here, you can write whatever you want to say or just put something here. It's not necessary, not mandatory. You can actually put it or not. And then you have two options. I go back to the part where you can download the Flash player. You also need the Java, remember? Flash player here. If you remember to update it, like I told you here, you press here, you open a new one, and this will come up. Just press here, and immediately you can update your Flash player into your browser. Okay. Sometimes it's done directly, sometimes not. Here's what you can do. Like you see, it only takes a few minutes. Remember that this is important that you do this, okay? 4 points are necessary. And you have two ways. Here, I don't know, I had just a minute ago, here normally you can see a button with a microphone. You press the button, you talk, and then you press again. Once you press a second time, it starts recording. So you have to wait until the play button appears, and then you can listen to it and just add. Or the other way is just to select a file. You can record it here and this one right here, and then just put it in the desktop, and then you add, okay? And the two ways you can use that. So it's very important that you can actually record these. Remember, it's important to have the 10 points. Now, what happens when you have it is that, wait one second here. Okay, here, you see this? You are going to do an exam at the end of the semester where it's which is worth 40 points, okay? 40 points. And your score must be 28 over 40 to be able to pass. 28 points, you pass. Remember that the platform gives you an extra 10 points, right? So let's say from the platform you have 8 points and something happened in your test and you only scored 20 points. But since you have 20 plus 8 points that you have from the platform equals 28, and you pass the semester, okay? So like I'm telling you, it's important to have some points here in that platform. But not only that, remember the platform, you're going to learn all the grammar, all the vocabulary, all the things you need to learn to be able to score or to have a great test, okay? Here, the only condition that you need to accomplish to obtain those points is to have 20 or more. If your score in the final presential evaluation is 19, the points for the platform are not added. Let's say you have 9 points in the platform, which is excellent, right? And your score in the test was 19. Well, your points are not going to be added and your final grade is 19, okay? Because it doesn't make sense that you have such a high score in the platform and not being able to have a minimum of 20, okay? So in that case, your points are not going to be added. You need a minimum of 20 so that your points from the platform are added to your final grade. And for the students that already have 28 in the exam, they're also going to be added the points from the platform. So let's say you have 28 in the exam, you pass, plus the 8 points you have in the platform, you pass with 36, which is also good because it makes your average go higher. Okay? So let's start. If you have any questions about the platform, please feel free to do it, to make all the questions. It's important that you are clear with all the things from the platform, okay? So if by any chance, any moment you need to ask something about the platform, please do so, okay? So we're gonna start with the presentation. Listen, the first thing is a review. That's what you have in the first part. Review of different tenses, okay? First, the review of the simple present tense, okay? So since you've been working the present tense with unit one, level one and level two, I don't think it will be a problem, okay? Subject plus verb plus object, and you have the simple present tense, right? To make a negative, to use a negative form with simple present, you have to use the auxiliaries don't and doesn't, okay? So if you want to change the sentence to the negative form in present tense, you only need to add doesn't or don't, depending on the conjugation of the verb. Remember, if it's singular in third person, we use doesn't. If it's plural, we use don't, okay? And to make questions, we only use do and does at the beginning of the sentence, then the subject, then the verb, and then the complement, okay? So this is like a little reminder of the first part, right? Only remember that the verb to be, you use it differently. Always the verb to be has a different treatment. I am Australian, he or she is clever. Remember, the verb to be is form of three, am is are, right? And for I is am, he, she, it, we use is. You, we, and they, we use are for plurals, okay? And the negative form for these are only adding not after the verb to be. This is just a review, okay? So, scroll for a bit more. I have some here. So remember, to make the negative form in the present tense, remember the present tense is this, right? The boy plays, in the present tense, you conjugate the verb by adding an S when it's singular. When it's singular, you add an S, okay? My friend, singular, you add S or ES to the verb. Then to make it negative, you use don't for plurals, I-N-U, and doesn't for singulars in the third person. So here's an example. The boy doesn't play. When you have an auxiliary, the verb returns to the original form, to the infinitive form. So it's only going to be played, not plays like here. The boy doesn't play in the park. My friend doesn't go to the library. To make a question, you only add does at the beginning of the sentence, and you have your question in the present tense. Does the boy play in the park? Yes, he does. No, he doesn't. Okay? And for plural, the boys play in the park, we use don't for plurals, okay? So, the boys don't play in the park. My students don't go to the library. And to make the question, same thing, we add the auxiliary at the beginning of the sentence. Do the boys play in the park? Yes, they do. No, they don't. Okay, so that's a little brief review of the simple present tense that you already have seen in the other two levels, okay? So don't forget about that. What are these in simple present tense? Normally they're facts, habitual actions, things that don't or won't change, or describing yourself, and so on. We also use the adverbs of frequency. I normally go to the university. I usually sleep early, okay? All these is used in the simple present tense. Okay, now, in the same unit one, after that review that you have on the simple present tense, we're going to have the use of to and either, okay? First, to, with double O, remember that, is to assure something affirmative, okay? Like in the example, I am allergic to cats. The other person might say, I am too, okay? I watch professional football. I do too. I can shop for hours. I can too. So you use to say that you also do that activity, okay? And that it's for two. And either, it's for negatives, okay? I am not an animal lover. I am not either. I don't watch much TV. I don't either. I can't afford anything new. I can't either. So that's the use of to and either, okay? To when you agree, either when you also disagree, okay? In a negative form. Unit two, the use of everybody and nobody, okay? These are indefinite pronouns, okay? To refer to people only, okay? So we use pronouns ending in body and one for people, and pronouns ending in thing for objects. For example, everybody enjoyed the concert. It means every single person enjoyed the concert. One more thing you need to know is that when you use everybody, even though you're talking about all the people, we use it as a simple present. I mean, you use it as a singular thing. So if I say everybody is, not everybody are, okay? Everybody is in the concert, for example. I opened the door, but nobody was there. Here, nobody is used to say that no one was there, that no person was there. So everybody includes everybody, all the people, and nobody, nobody. No people were there. It was a very clear day. We couldn't see we could see everything. And for things, we use everything. And negative, nothing, okay? So everybody, nobody, and everything, nothing, okay? Now, we use a singular verb after an indefinite pronoun, what I was telling you. Even though it includes everybody, all the people, when you say everybody, you have to conjugate the verb like it was singular. So everybody is in the class. Everybody loves Sally. Okay? When we refer back to an indefinite pronoun, we use a plural pronoun. Like, everybody loved the game. So remember, when we look back, everybody loved the game. They stood up and clapped for 15 minutes. We use indefinite pronouns with no as the subject in negative clauses, not pronouns with any. Okay, so in negative, for negatives, we use no, nobody, nothing. And you have to be careful of not committing the mistake of putting double negatives. Here, for example, anybody didn't come to the party. Anybody is like positive, affirmative. So you put the negative form here, didn't come to the party. And the similar way to put is nobody came to the party. Now, what I'm referring is be avoiding the double negative is that sometimes we commit a mistake. Okay, we say, if I ask you, is somebody in the class? You say, nobody. Double negative, like, for example, I didn't see nobody, for example. I didn't see nobody, teacher. This one is incorrect. Why? Because nobody is already a negative. You cannot write two negatives right here. Okay? So remember, double negatives are not accepted. If you want to use this, you will say you eliminate this or you change this one to anybody. I didn't see anybody or I saw or I saw nobody. But you can't write double negatives, okay? And so on for everything. Okay? And so that's what you need to be careful when you use when you use the infinitive pronouns, okay? Unit 3. Simple present tense and present continuous. Okay, remember we reviewed already the simple present tense, and now we're going to see the difference with present continuous. Present continuous is formed by has the following structure, right? You have the subject, then you have the verb to be, it's important, plus the verb of action, the verb with the ing form, right? So try to think in one sentence. I'll give you 1 minute, okay? Yeah, I don't know. I see a student there. Can you manage to make a sentence, please, with simple present progressive using this form? I'm going to start with one, and then you give me another one, okay? For example, the verb to be, he we use is working in the hospital, for example. He's working in the hospital, okay? Can you make another one, please? Can you get the microphone? Maybe you can ask there for a microphone to the people from UTPL. Alguien, por favor, que le pueda pasar el micrófono al estudiante para que me pueda contestar. Gracias.
Good afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon. Can you please help me with a sentence?
Yes, I have a question.
Okay.
When I use nobody,
Yes.
always I need to use didn't before the verb.
No. Actually, it's the contrary. You cannot use didn't or any negative with nobody. Let me explain. I cannot put this. I didn't see nobody. This is incorrect. This you cannot do because this is negative. Didn't is negative and nobody is also negative. So you have here a mistake because you have double negative. You can write here instead of, if you want to put didn't, you have to put here any. You can put, I didn't see anybody. That is correct. Or you can just put the verb here without didn't. You can say, I saw nobody, for example. Okay? So the important thing is not to use, oh, sorry, nobody here. No. I saw, oops, second. I saw nobody. That will be correct. Okay? So nobody, nothing, nowhere, everything with a no, it's going to be already negative. So you don't need to put the negative again, okay? Yes? Okay. This is with a nobody and nothing, okay? And if you want to use for affirmative, you must, well, where was that? Here. If you want to use affirmative, you have to say everybody. So everybody was in the class, everybody was inside the school, everybody was in the concert, like that. Remember, you cannot, if you want to use nobody, you cannot use didn't, don't, doesn't, nothing like that, because it will make a problem. It will become a double negative, and that is a mistake, okay? It's a regular mistake. Actually, it's more, there's some people saying, oh, teacher, I didn't bring nothing, right? I didn't bring nothing. And that is a mistake because I didn't and bring nothing, double negative. So you can say, I didn't bring anything. Or you can also say, I brought nothing. Okay? So that is how you use this, okay? I don't know if you have another question with this.
No yet, no yet.
No problem. So I'm going to review here. Remember, we have the present tense and the present continuous. Okay? The present tense we reviewed at the beginning. Now we're reviewing the present continuous, like I told you. Okay? The present continuous is only this. Remember, the subject, verb to be, and then the verb with ing. These go together always in the present continuous. Okay? He is working. She is. Let's go with she. No, they are. They are playing soccer, for example. Okay? So they always go together. Yes? And just to remind you how to make the negative form, in this case, is only you add after the verb to be. He is not playing, or he is not working, sorry. Working. In the hospital. He's not working in the hospital, etc. Okay? That would be like the way you turn into a negative in this term. And just to remind you, if you want to make a sentence, up a question, you just put this is at the beginning of the sentence, okay? And it will become a question. Okay? So the present continuous has this structure, okay? Subject, verb to be, and verb with ing. as important. So, more than after this, remember the keywords that help you identify that this is a present progressive, that you have the things in present progressive. So the keywords will be, for example, at this moment. This means that if I see this at this moment during in a sentence, you know that that sentence is in present progressive, okay? If I see at present, also is the same thing, present. Or the famous now. I am cleaning the house now. Okay? If you see one of the three words, these three words right here, they indicate that it's the present progressive. Okay? So let's recap. Remember, is not. You put not after the verb to be and it becomes negative. Same thing here. For example, if I want to change this one to a negative form, you only put here aren't and that's negative form. Okay? And if you want to make a question, just in case you they tell you to make a question, you have to put are. You only add change the verb to the beginning. Are they playing soccer? And that's it. Okay. Wait to answer with a verb to be. Yes, they are. And no, they're not. Okay. So it's important in the verb to be to know these things. For the other one, for the present continue, for the simple present tense, how to identify if you have today or if you have routine habits, like here, this says daily routine habits. Like I usually go to the movies, I normally, using all those, any word that shows you that you do it every day is simple present tense, okay? Permanent situations, I work in a bank, it's also going to be present tense. Facts, things are true. The river Thames flows through London. Or timetables in an immediate future. The train leaves at 9:11 p.m. Okay? In the present continuous is something that is in progress, something that you're doing that moment. I am watching TV now. Maybe something that's going to be arranged in the future. I am meeting my friends with this afternoon, or something temporary. I'm leaving in New York. Okay, that is when you use a simple present tense and the present continuous. Okay, but remember, normally it's easier to see when you have these keywords that I told you. Okay. Okay. Now, then we have the part with if and when, okay? Normally they're joining clauses. That means they put together two sentences, okay? If and when are used to put together two sentences, two clauses. Clause is similar to a sentence, okay? So I don't take anything when I am cold, okay? I'm putting together these two sentences. This one right here in this is an independent sentence and this is a dependent sentence. Normally, when this word that joins the two sentences is in the middle of the two, we do not separate with a comma, okay? We don't use a comma. And when this word is at the beginning of the sentence, to separate the two sentences, we use a comma, okay? You can see that this sentence is the same as the other one. I don't take anything when I'm cold. When I am cold, comma, I don't take anything. It's the same sentence. But this clause right here goes first now. And because this word is not in the middle, we separate with a comma. Okay? Now, same thing goes for if. If I get really bad cold, comma, I drink hot vinegar with honey. Since the first clause is here, we separate with a comma. First in translation, I don't take anything when I'm cold. Yo no tomo nada cuando tengo un resfriado. If I get really bad cold, I drink hot vinegar with honey. Si es que tengo una gripe bastante fuerte, me tomo una vinagre con miel, okay? So, and when this clause is in the middle, you do not use the comma, okay? When you have any question, just tell me. You stop, okay? And I'll interrupt me. Now we're going to the part of future with going to, okay? Remember, there's two ways of making the future, with will and with going to. And this time we're going to do with is going to. Okay, Jane is going to visit her parents next week. It's a way of putting things into the future. Normally, you use is going to or are going to when you have plans that are already scheduled, plans that you already made, things are sure. Unlike with present continuous, that is something you when not need not. It doesn't need future time words to indicate the future when you use the present continuous, like in the example it was here. I am leaving in New York. Temporary things. Okay? The future with is going to, the structure is the following. He, for example, is, well, let's put there because the example there is already with they. The verb to be are going to, and then the verb. This goes together. This is like one thing, okay? This like goes together. And then the verb. They are going to fly. Then you have to put the verb, any verb that you are going to use. Fly to New York, for example. Okay? They are going to fly to New York. So this part right here is the one that makes it future. Okay, so that's like a way of making the future. We can also have other sentences like my friend is going to play soccer, okay? Tomorrow. Okay, it gives you the future tense using this. Okay? Is going to, are going to. That makes the sentence future. Now, keywords to know when you use a future. You have tomorrow and everything related to next. Next week, next month, oops, next month, next year, next Tuesday, everything with next, okay? That tells you that you're going to do it in the future. I don't know if you want me to review maybe to make negatives here, to make a negative sentence here. The only thing you need to do is to add here, not after the verb to be, is not or isn't. My friend isn't going to play soccer tomorrow, okay? To make a negative, you only add not here or isn't is the same thing. Okay? And that's how you make the negative form in this kind of future. Okay? And if you want to make the question, if you want to make a question, you just take this is and put it at the very beginning. And that's a question. Is my friend, sorry, wait 1 second. Let's capitalize this word. Is my friend going to play soccer tomorrow? And it becomes a question, okay? That's the only way you can change it easily to a question, okay? Okay, so listen. Do me a favor, okay? I want you to make a sentence. Write one sentence in the future using is or are going to, okay? What is your name, sorry? The one that has a... What's your name?
Name is Johnny.
Okay, Johnny. Please make a sentence, and then we're going to make you do this. Change it to negative, and then to a question, okay?
Negative. Okay.
Make a sentence first, okay? Give me a sentence.
First, I give you a sentence.
Yeah.
Okay. If you, I need to use going to.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. We are. Okay. A ver. We are going to. Are going to cook. To cook. A chicken for Christmas.
What? I'm gonna change to turkey, okay? Because it's a typical
thing. That's all. Turkey for Christmas.
Okay. There you go. Very good. We are going to cook a turkey for Christmas. Excellent work, okay? Now, change it to negative.
We are not going to cook a turkey for Christmas.
Yeah, we are not going to cook a turkey for Christmas. Good. And now, can you make the question, please?
Yes. Are we going to cook a turkey for Christmas?
Perfect. So I want to ask you, are we going to cook a turkey for Christmas? Answer yes and no.
Yes, we are. Yeah. Sure or?
Short is okay.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are and no, we are not.
Perfect. Okay. So I think it's clear. Okay. You're okay with that, right? Or you have another question maybe about distance? Do you understand this future? No problem?
Yes.
Perfect. Okay. Okay. So let's continue.
Give me 1 minute. I am going to the bath.
Yeah, no problem.
I come back. Thank you, teacher.
No problem. Okay. So, okay, let's go with no problem. No questions here, right? You're okay with it, right? You understand? Okay, so let's go with the next thing. Okay, in Unit 5, you saw the simple past and some expressions, okay? So we're going to go over, this is the most important ones that you have in that part, okay? Okay, so, for example, where were you born? This is normally a problem. Normally, some people get confused with the idea of where how to use this word, okay? So where were you born? I was born in Quito. I wasn't born in Cuenca. Okay, that's one way. Next one, do you live there for a long time? Yes, I did. I lived there for 10 years. No, I didn't. I didn't live there for long. Well, I didn't live there long. Okay? Where were your parents born? They were born. Remember where? Where is the past of are? Okay? Remember is, was, and are, where, right? They were born in Quito too. Here's the use of two, remember? They weren't born in Salinas. Did she move here last year? Yes, she did. She moved in May. Or no, she didn't. She moved in 91. How long did you live in Ambato? We lived there until I was six, from 1986 to 1992. Where did they come here? When did they come here? Sorry. They came here about 3 years ago. We didn't leave until 1992. Then we came to the US when Juan was 16. Okay? They're just expressions using time. For a long time, for example. That is an expression. Last for 10 years. So it's important for a long time. Normally four, and you want to say how many years, okay? For 10 years, for 5 years. And the other one, since, I think we have it some here, some here. Here. Where was it? Since. Well, if you want to use since, you have to put a point in the past, since 1992, for example, okay? So I don't know, this, it's only things that you're talking about in the past, okay? Determiners here, what we're talking about is all, most, some, a few, and no. Okay, these are general. What do I mean with general? That I don't know exactly who it is, okay? It's general, it could be any people, okay? So when I say all children can learn English, I don't know exactly who I'm talking about. I'm just saying anybody, right? Any kid. Most Canadians know French in general, again. Some students take Spanish. A few people are good at math. No students like exams, okay? This determiners are only in general. We are not talking about a specific group or a specific people, somebody, okay? It's general. Now, if we go to the specific ones here, right here, all of the children here, when you say all of the children, we're trying to specify maybe a group, right? All of the children here speak English. Most of, when you use most of my coworkers know French, we're specifying, okay? Most of my coworkers know French. Some, you see the same some, but we put off and we change to a specific. Some of the students in my class take math. A few of my classmates got A's. That means excellent grades. None of my friends failed their exam. Okay? So this form just makes it more specific. Okay? We're referring to a group now, not to anybody or in general. Okay?
Question: what's the meaning of co-workers? No, only
Okay,
co-workers.
co-workers. Co-workers means compañeros de trabajo.
Compañeros de
Compañeros.
trabajo. And
That's why we have.
most of my co-workers know French. Significa la most muchos o la mayoría de mis compañeros de trabajo conocen Francia.
No, saben
No,
francés.
francés, saben francés.
Exactly. That is correct.
Okay.
Yes. So all, todos, most, la mayoría de, some of, alguno de mis estudiantes, a few of my classmates, algunos de mis estudiantes, de mis compañeros, perdón, no, none of my friends, ninguno de mis amigos. Okay? That's what it means. Okay? Now, offers and requests. Offers of ofrecimientos and requests, peticiones, ¿sí? Peticiones. With can and would. Okay? Offers, ofrecimientos, y esos son peticiones. We're going to see the difference. Okay? Can I help you? Cuando alguien te pregunta, can I help you? That is an offer. Es un ofrecimiento. Okay? Can I help you? But when I say it like this, can you help me? Es una petición. Es del otro lado. Can I help you? El que quiere ayudar pregunta al otro. En cambio, can you help me? Es en cambio un estoy requiriendo yo ayuda. Can you help me? Okay? Entonces es de los dos bandos, como dices. The other one. What can I do for you? What can I do for you? ¿Qué puedo hacer por ti? Can you tell me how to get to the mall? Ahora es request. Yo estoy pidiendo. Can you tell me how to get to the mall? ¿Me podría decir cómo llegar al mall? Ofrecimiento. How can I help you? ¿Cómo te puedo ayudar? And the other one, request. Could you give me directions? ¿Me puedes dar direcciones o instrucciones? Okay. So that's the difference between offer and request. It's important that you know how to, because sometimes we want to say an offer and we say a request. So it's important to know how, okay? In the unit 7, we saw infinitives for reasons, okay? For reasons. What is infinitive first? So you can. Infinitive means this way of using the sentence, the verb, to buy, to find, to play, to, and the verb is called infinitive, yes? So this is the infinitive, okay? And we are using this form of the verb to give reason, to give you a reason of something, okay? Here goes the example. I am working, sorry, I am going to the store. And you want to give the reason, right? Why, right? Why you're going to the store. So I'm going to the store, and then you give the reason with the infinitive to buy some milk. That's the purpose, why you're going. Okay, you're giving the reason why you're going. Estoy dando la razón por cual me voy. I am going to the store to buy some milk. I have to go online to find a flight. Para encontrar un vuelo. I am going home to see my family. Voy a la casa para ver a mi familia. So this is when we use this infinitive to buy, to find, to see, like that, to give the reason why you're doing something, okay? And in the second one, we're going to do the same thing, but now we're going to use the adjective, this adjective, easy, important, hard, okay? It's easy to shop online, okay? It's easy to shop online. Okay, I'm giving you like I'm explaining why. It's important to sleep 8 hours every day. It's important to sleep 8 hours every day, every night. It's hard to work two full-time jobs. It's hard to work two full-time jobs, okay? So it's just a comparison. Now, I want to give advice or and suggestions. Okay? I want to give advice, sugerencias, and suggestions. Sugerencias. Okay? Sugerencias. Here we go. What should I take? Should I take this jacket? Eso es para preguntar por sugerencias de mi lado. Cuando yo pregunto sugerencias, se llama advice. Okay? What should I take? Estoy preguntando, ¿qué debería llevar? Should I take this jacket? ¿Debería llevar esta chaqueta? Y ahora voy a utilizar como sugerencia. You shouldn't do that. No deberías hacer eso. You could borrow my coat. Podrías tomar prestado mi chaqueta. You need to have warm clothes. Tú necesitas tener ropa cálida. Why don't you take a hat? Why don't you take a hat? ¿Por qué no llevas un sombrero? Don't forget to bring your passport. No te olvides de traer un pasaporte, tu pasaporte. So this is suggestions that you give or you receive, okay? So that's advice and suggestions. Now, when you have a question with whose, we're asking about the ownership of something. Who is the owner? Who, where, what belongs to who? Okay? Now listen. There are two ways we can use this possessive, right? You see here, my, your, her, his, our, their. Or this one's right here, mine, yours. You see that ends with an S. My, mine. Your, yours. Her, hers. His is the same. Our, ours. Their, theirs. Now, there's a different use for each one of these. When we use my, for example, always we need to put something beside. Always we have to say something, okay? For example, my car, my jacket, my something. It cannot be alone. Always with something. Same thing over here. Your hat, for example. Your hat, your car, your something. Cannot put only your, okay? Her sweater. Okay? Always has something beside. On the contrary, a diferencia de this one, you can use it alone. For example, that is mine. You do not put something beside. No pones nada al lado. Mine, I cannot say mine car. Incorrect. Okay? When you use this one, it's alone, nothing beside. Okay? And when you use this with no S, you need to put something beside. Okay? And here we have the examples. Whose clothes are this? It's my bathing suit. You see? It means a bathing suit belongs to me. Your earnings. It's her jewelry, the jewelry from her. Okay? You put her and then beside something. There are his and then shoes. You have to put something beside this. They're our things. It's their stuff. Stuff is the same as things. Okay? When you use these, I do not use anything beside. It's mine. They're yours. It's hers, they're his, they're ours, it's theirs. Okay? So that's how you use it. Now, normally when there's more than one adjective, it is important to organize them in the correct form. Okay? When I say, for example, the red car. Right, the red car is easy. You put the adjective before the subject, right? Let me just go up. It's easy when you put only the red car, right? Because we put red, the adjective goes before, right? But now, if I want to put more than one adjective, more than one, sometimes you get confused where to put. I can put, let me, I'm gonna put incorrect. If I say this, for example, the red big car, okay? It sounds also nice. It's the same thing, right? You don't know if it's which, you don't know which one to put, right? So the idea here is that you can actually, you have to organize your adjectives, okay, in a specific order. They have, you cannot say red big car or big red car, okay? So we have an order. As you can see here, first goes the size. So this, for example, like I told you, is incorrect. Which one goes first? First will go the size. First I have to say a big red car, okay? It's how I organize the things here, okay? And here, this is important. Here is the options of how to organize. Okay, first opinion, then size, then color, then shape, then nationality, and then material. Okay, that's the order I should follow. So here, look, sofa is the noun, the thing, right? And these are three adjectives. So how to organize them is important. I cannot say they have a leather Italian huge sofa. That would be incorrect. The correct form would be first, look, we have to put the material. The material is leather, cuero. Then the nationality, Italian. Then the shape, but shape is not here. Color is not here. And then size, huge is size. So huge Italian leather sofa. Okay, in the next one, I want those cool little round speakers. Cool little round speakers. So why like that in that order? Because like it says here on top here, first goes a material, no material, so no problem. Then nationality, no nationality. Shape, yes, round. Then color, no color here. Size, little. In my opinion, cool. Okay? The next. Next one is... yes?
I have a question.
Please.
What's the meaning of round?
Round means it's like a circle. Redondo.
Ah, redondo. En eso, en, allí significa redondo porque también puede significar alrededor de o no. O para decir alrededor de es around.
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 Around. Okay.
Round.
A little, sorry, I like the green rug. Which one do you like? Green rug. Rug, alfombra, no? O tapete, me dice, una cosa. Rug es el pequeño, ¿no? No la alfombra que va todo el cuarto, sino solo la como rodapiés. Una alfombra, nada más. Pero no la que cubre todo el cuarto. Those speakers are cool. Which ones do you like? Okay. So if I tell you those speakers are cool, which ones do you like? You can say, I like the cool, big, yellow, round, Italian or American speakers. You see? You can, this is the order you have to follow. Okay? Okay. Past continuous statements. Here we go with the past tense. This in a minute. But before we do that, please, I'm going to ask you a question and you answer following this. Okay? Which kind of cars do you like?
Of cars do I like?
Uh-huh. Give me the characteristics.
I like deportivos está bien, sports cars.
Yes, I want you to use more than one adjective.
I like
figure this out.
I need to use this order: opinion, size, color, shape, nationality,
Yeah.
material. Okay.
Yeah, maybe you don't need to put all of them, but use some.
Okay. Of course. I like big cars. Okay. I like big blue shape in shape.
If you don't have a shape, skip.
Okay. Italian, a Lamborghini, for example.
Yeah.
Italian and
Car. Enough.
Car.
You cannot use everything in all of them, okay? Like here, you see you only use three and so on, okay? You don't need to use all of this type of adjectives, okay?
For opinion, is possible classic cars?
Could be. Could be your opinion, but opinion goes more to what you think about the car. Yeah, you could say it's classic. Yes, it could be your opinion. But it goes more to what you think about the car. But it's okay if you put classic, brown, American car, okay? Now, I was going to tell you that for the past continuous, we use the same structure that we used for the present continuous, okay? The only difference is that we're going to put the verb to be in past. Remember that when I'm going to put a normal one, okay? For example, they are playing soccer, we had, right? Soccer. That is the present continuous, right? To change to past continuous, the only thing you need to do is to change the verb to be to past, okay? So are is incorrect. Are changes to were. Okay, remember this. So, am and is change to was, and are changes to were. Okay, so they were playing soccer. This would be already the past progressive. Okay, now when do we use the past progressive? Right? Or the past continuous use to set the background for a story, something that happened in the past or you did in the past doing something, as well as for events that progress in the past, something that happened in the past while you were doing something, or simple past is used for complete the action. Here we have the examples. I was talking to a woman and I missed my stop. You see, some action that happened in the past while you were doing something, okay? I wasn't paying attention. They were trying to look cool. I don't know if you understand the sentence. I was talking to a woman, estaba hablando con una chica, and I missed my stop, y perdí la parada. I wasn't paying attention, no estuve poniendo atención. We were trying to look cool, and we walked into a glass door. We weren't looking. Okay, so that's when you use the past continuous to tell you what you were doing in the past, okay, what you were doing other things. Now, to change it to question, the only thing you do to change it, well, for negative, easy, right? We only... Since it's a verb to be there, the only thing you need to negative is to put an apostrophe T here, and that's negative, right? They weren't playing soccer. And to make a question, we move the verb to be to the beginning. Were they playing soccer? And that's it, okay? Were they playing soccer? And this could have only two possible, right? Yes, They were. And no, they weren't. Okay? Yeah. Now, past continuous and reflexive pronouns. Remember the reflexive pronouns. Same. I, myself. This is important to like remember. Sometimes people get confused. Instead of writing ourselves, they put, for example, us selves. So this is important to memorize, okay? You need to know the correct use of this one. Or some people put, instead of themselves, they put their selves, and it's incorrect. Or another typical mistake is to write this one, ourself. That is incorrect, okay? Because our is plural, so it's not ourself, it's ourselves. Okay? So it's very important to check. These are the only combinations, the only way. So I hurt myself. That would be when you hit yourself, right? Against something. You hit yourself. He hurt himself. Él se hirió a él mismo, o se golpeó a él mismo. She hit herself. We hit ourselves, and they hit themselves. These are reflexive pronouns, pronombres reflexivos, okay? Okay, now, comparative and superlative. I'm gonna put, now. So, to form the comparative superlative, first, if it has one syllable adjectives, and you are going to put ER or EST. How? Like this. Softer, cheaper, you see? Sweeter, sorry, and thinner. When you compare two things, you add only ER to the adjective. Cheaper ER, sweeter ER, and thinner ER. When you make the superlative, what is a comparative? When I compare two things, that car is, that car, yes, is bigger than mine. So when you say bigger than, you're comparing two things. Okay? That's why I put ER, bigger. Yes? Now, superlative. What is the superlative form? The superlative form is when I compare one thing to the group. Okay? That means that car is the best or the biggest car of the parking lot. My car is the biggest car of the parking, el más grande of the parking lot. Okay? So that's, how do I use that? I have to add EST, best or biggest. Okay? So let me write it down. When you put the comparative, why do I do this? For adjectives that are small, one syllable, for example, big, small, for example, small. If I'm comparing two things, I use smaller, always ER. And the superlative, I need to say smallest, EST. Okay? So we are ER, and we are EST for superlative. What is comparative? We compare two groups, two things, okay? And superlative, we compare one to the group, okay? Peter is smaller than Mark. Peter is smaller than Mark, comparing Mark and Peter, two people. Peter is smaller than Mark. But then, when I compare one to the group, that is going to be the superlative. Peter is the smallest student. Okay? Smaller. And normally this goes like this, smaller than. And this one over here always, always has the small, the biggest, the smallest, the everything, okay? So, as you can see here, always, always the, okay? So spelling rules, when it's one syllable, like here, thin, we duplicate the end, okay?
Excuse me, teacher.
Yes?
Is there a special rule for comparative and superlative, always I need to add air for comparative and s for superlative?
No, there's like three rules. Okay.
Okay.
The first rule is when it's one consonant, when it's small. When it's small, we put this, ER and EST, okay? Now, when verbs, when they are two syllables or more, when they are bigger, two syllables or more, we don't put ER. We do not put ER. Okay, what we do is, for example, this one, worried or boring, you careful, useless. These are have two syllables or three, no problem. You put more for comparative and you do not use ER. When it's more than one syllable, we do not use ER. We put more. Expensive, for example, expensive. Yes? And if it's superlative, the most expensive. So we use now more and the most. These two words are important. When they're big adjectives, this we put, and you never put ER here. You cannot say more, expensier. You cannot combine, okay? Only this. Okay? So, like here, more useful, more careful, more boring, like that. And superlative, the most worried, the most boring, the most, like that. And for three syllables, the same thing, you see? The most, more dangerous, more difficult, the most dangerous, the more, most difficult, okay? Now, there are exceptions, okay? There are three syllables, adjectives that have been formed by adding the prefix un. When you have unhappy, you put happy first, unhappy, unhappier, and the unhappiest. This is an exception because unhappy, for example, right? And here you add ER only. These are exceptions, okay? Now, the third rule is they are irregular adjectives, okay? These ones do not have a rule. They only change. Like good, you don't say gooder. Or you don't say more good, no, incorrect. More good is incorrect and gooder is incorrect. When you want to say that something is better than, okay? You use better than. He is better than him. Or that car is better than mine, okay? Better than. And when you want to compare with the rest, the best car, the best student, the best, not the goodest. Or the most good, no, incorrect. The best is the word, okay? And for bad, bad, worse, he is worse than him, or the worst car. Okay, and there we have this far, to describe something is farther than. And here we have farther and further. You can use farther and further in specific cases, though. Do you want to ask something?
This is incorrect. Tell, for example, you are more good father than me.
Incorrect. You are You are a better father than me.
You are a better father than me. Okay.
Mm-hmm. That is incorrect. It does not exist. Okay. And this one right here, farther. You see, you have two options. And in the movies, probably you hear sometimes they say farther and sometimes they say further. It's the same, the farthest or the furthest. This has one rule, okay? I use farther when it relates to distance. For example, my house is farther from your house. Or your ball went farther than mine. So we use farther and farthest when it's something related to distance, okay, to physical distance. Now, we use further when it's something that went beyond, in not in distance, but in anything, in knowledge or in any other thing that is not distance. For example, your investigation went further than mine. Okay, the investigation went further, más allá. Okay, further, but it's not related to distance. Okay, it's related to more research or whatever. Okay, so then we use further. Okay, and farther is for physical distance. That's why we have the two options here. Okay, and remember when we compare, normally we use than, like it is he, John is taller than me. And when we use superlatives, we always use the biggest, the smallest, okay, like that, okay? So here we have some examples. Rules, here are the rules. Adjectives, you add ER if they have one syllable, okay? More or less if they have adjectives with three or more syllables, okay? Irregular adjectives change, like good, better, bad, worse, worst. And here are examples. Email is quicker than regular mail. Letters are more personal than emails. Driving is less expensive than flying. Using Skype is better than a regular phone call. Spam is worse than regular junk mail. Okay. Now, when to use more or less and fewer. Remember that there were countable nouns and uncountable nouns. I remember when you say, for example, water. You cannot say one water, two waters, three waters. Incorrect. Right? You cannot count water. So I can say there is much water. Okay? And remember that bread or, no, not bread. Let's say pen, you can count. One pen, two pens, three pens. So that's a countable noun. Okay? So more we can use for countable and non-countable. More calls, more time. Okay? More. She talks more. Fewer means the opposite of more, right? Fewer opposite. You can use it only fewer for countable. You get fewer calls, okay? So when you use fewer, the next word must have an S or ES because it must be plural, right? Fewer calls, fewer pens, fewer markers than me. You have fewer markers, something like that, okay? But when there is something you cannot count, you use less. You spend less time on the phone. You have less water than me. Okay? Because water you cannot count. So you cannot say, I have fewer water than you. No, I have less water. less time, okay? So always after less, this word right here is always going to be with no S, no ES, not in plural, okay? Now, he talks less. Yes?
Can you repeat? I don't understand when I need to use less. Okay. Less similar than fewer.
Fewer is used when you can count the following word. Okay, when you can count. Okay, you can say fewer pens, fewer cars, fewer trees. But things you cannot count, that are not countable, like water, salt, you use less. Less salt, less water. Okay, perfect. And she talks less. Also before, after, ever. Yes?
Excuse me, it's probably to say you give less love than me.
Yes.
Love is uncountable noun.
Correct. It's uncountable.
Okay. Correct. Thanks.
Perfect. So that's correct. Okay, so he talks less than, here we're demonstrating only when it's after a verb, okay? Hablar menos, hablar más, okay? Es solo cuando se utiliza, ¿no? En el caso aquí sí se puede utilizar more, talks more, habla más, talks less. Se utiliza less, not fewer, okay? Con los verbos. Okay, and that's it. Okay, describing people with have got. That's what we're going to do. How to describe people with have got. And have got. No, later have got. So, what does Samantha look like? ¿Cómo se ve Samantha? ¿Cómo, cuál es su apariencia? She's short and thin. She's fat and beautiful. Or she is beautiful and thin. Whatever, okay? What color is her hair? It's blonde. Okay? How tall is she? She's 5'3" tall. That's, or she is 135 meters, for example, okay? Something like that. And now have got. Have got means to have, okay? So who's got curly hair? I do. I have got curly hair, okay? When you specify, you describe somebody. Okay, I have got blonde hair. I have got the latest Nintendo. I have got beautiful eyes, like that. Okay? Okay, we're gonna go to the next part. Wait. Okay, also, phrases with verb plus ing and preposition. Okay, so we're going to see. She is the woman standing by the door. Here, why we use it like this? Because remember, this is a verb, right? With ing. But we're using it, and after this needs to come up this preposition, by. She is the woman standing by the door. I'm describing where she is, okay? He is the man walking through the patio, for example, okay? So we use it like that with ing when we want to say or describe a little bit more where she is, okay? She's the woman wearing the black dress, okay? When we want to describe, we use standing, we use wearing, we put the verb in ing. She is the girl talking to the other people, okay? She's the one by, wait, when do we use preposition? We want to tell where she is, right? She's the one by the table with the short hair in the white shirt. We're describing the person to identify. She's the one by the table. She's the one with short hair. She's the one in the white shirt. Who's the guy in the purple shirt? Which one? The one with the glasses. Okay? Here's a use. The one with the glasses. That's Diego. Okay? So we can use the verb with ing to continue describing, or just the preposition, like here. Okay? Future. We have the future now with will, with may, or with might. We use will to give facts or predictions about the future. It will be expensive to travel in Europe. It will be 36 in April. I will be 36 in April, sorry. It won't be easy to find a job next week. Okay? So it's like a prediction, right? We use may and might to show you are not 100% sure, okay, of something. You are not sure you're going to do this future event. So if I'm not sure I'm going to do that in the future, but I'm talking in the future, I use may or might. I may get a master's degree next year. I might be able to buy a car if I stop going out. I may not have time to eat today. I might not go to the party on Friday, okay? So it's a possibility in the future, okay? So that's the thing, okay? It's a possibility in the future, and that's when we use may and might and so on. Present tense verbs with future meaning, okay? This is like sometimes, if we use it correctly, we can use the present tense to say something in the we want to say something from the future. With compound complex sentences about the future, using simple present and after, if, when, after, and before. Okay, what are you going to do when you graduate? You see, what are you going to do when you graduate? ¿Qué vas a hacer cuando te gradúes? The question, the sentence, the question in this case is in future. ¿Qué vas a hacer cuando te gradúes? Estoy esperando cuando me gradúe en futuro. Pero este when hace que esta oración que está puesta originalmente en presente, mira, se refiera al futuro. ¿Okay? A otra forma, con if también hay como. If I get good grades, si es que saco buenas notas, I may go to medical school. The sentence together, si aquí yo veo solo esta parte, I may go to medical school, no estaría, sino que como la unión con el if, cuando tenga buenas notas, me iré al medical school, hace que sea la oración en futuro. Okay. My parents will be disappointed if I don't go into medicine. My parents will be disappointed if I don't go into medicine. After I graduate, I will work in a hospital. After I graduate, I will work in a hospital. And I need to decide before I go home for the summer. I need to decide before I go home. Okay, so these are like present tense, but with this, they make it future. Okay, and that is the review of the grammar part. Now I want to ask you if you have any questions about anything, about the platform or about the grammar.
Thank you. I don't have any questions.
Okay, so please just remember one more thing. When you are in the platform and you have to study for the test, it's almost impossible to go over all the platform to see what you study, right? It's very difficult. It's impossible because the platform has a lot, right? So when you want to study for the evaluation that we're going to have, There is a part that is called reference, okay? In that part that is called reference, I'm going to show you right now. Here, you see reference. You press here, and you have the summary of everything in grammar. For example, the grammar of Unit 1, the grammar of Unit 4, you press here, and it gives you examples, you see? And that's the way you can study. The grammar, the vocabulary of Unit 1, of Unit 2, of Unit 3, and the conversation strategies are the things that you can find in a test, okay? So the grammar, the vocabulary, and the conversation strategies, you can study for any evaluation or review, if you want to see what's more difficult for you or anything, okay? So this is a good way of studying. Okay, so if you don't have any more questions, thank you very much. Remember to write your tutor. If you have any other, if you want to ask for something or you're doubting on something, just ask your tutor, okay? Do you have any more questions? No? Yes?
No, thanks.
Okay. So I have nothing else. If you're done, you can. Thank you very much for coming, okay?